Antonites, I was in the grocery store today and I essentially made a bucket list. I went to the grocery store and I'm like, bucket, bucket, bucket. Everything I didn't know what it was, I bought. We're gonna try some fruits that I've never tried before in my life that I found here in the Philippines. This plate we have mangosteen, Davao pomelo, dragon fruit, guava, and something I have never heard of before called chesa. I think I dated a girl named chesa once. This passionate green one, passion fruit. So as you can tell, I've got this huge knife because some of these I have no idea how I'm supposed to get into. For instance, this mangosteen, which some people pronounce as mangosteen, but I've been told by the locals it's mangosteen. Like, it's not an easy fruit to get into. So we may be doing some fruit ninja stuff up in here. So first, because this one actually came from the grocery store pre-peeled, or sort of they took it out of the thing. The pomelo, was grown here locally in Davao. This is probably the most mentioned fruit in my comments section. Hopefully, I'll love it just as much as you guys keep telling me I should. So, people keep telling me this is kind of like a grapefruit. It seems a little bit drier than a grapefruit. And it's a lot more fibrous than I was anticipating. It's not bad, but it's definitely not what I was expecting based on what people were telling me it was. But it doesn't seem as dry when I eat the little, like when I just pick off like one of the little cells. It doesn't seem as dry. So let's try it with a little pinch of salt. Not for me. And we are going to do this one, the passion fruit, next. Let's go ahead and slice into that and see what that is. Have you ever had passion fruit? Let me know in the comment section down below. Also, let me know how you like it. Like, are there any desserts or dishes or anything like that you prefer it in? Ooh! Ooh! This doesn't look like a passion fruit. If anything, this kind of looks like an orange on the inside. Hold on, wait a minute. Hold up, wait a minute. This kind of tastes like dandan, but I've never seen a dandan this big. I thought dandan was like teeny tiny, like a calamansi. This is amazing. So I have to admit my own ignorance here. This was under the sign that said passion fruit in the grocery store. So I assumed that that's what it was because I had never seen a fruit like this. So I'm gonna slice this open a little bit more and we're gonna take a big hefty bite. I love dandan. I normally like drink dandan flavored drinks. Same question though for you. If you really like dandan, and I'm probably saying that wrong, I'm sorry. If you really like it, let me know in the comment section down below how you like to eat it, or you know, drink it, or whatever you do. Oh my god, this is so sweet. Delicious. So yeah, that was an interesting experiment. So I'm gonna put all this stuff off to the side and I'm maybe gonna make some dandan juice or something, or maybe just eat some more later. So next, we're about to go all fruit ninja on this magical looking fruit right here. It's all pink on the outside and it's got these little things, and I mean, I have seen, I guess, like pictures of dragon fruit before, but I don't think I've ever eaten one, and I don't really know what to expect. This is gonna be a whole different kind of experiment for me. It's just like, what? It looks like some kind of, I don't even know what to call this. It looks like a fruit from another planet. I'm gonna stop worrying about that and I'm just gonna cut into it. I don't know if it has a pit or anything. I'm just gonna go. Oh, that was actually really easy. Ooh, it's really got a red juice too. Ooh, and the meat, like not the meat of the fruit. It has like this awesome coloring to it. Oh my goodness. I'll be honest, kind of bland. I mean, it's sweet and it's got I think that this would be really, really good if it were really cold. But right now, at just a little bit colder than room temperature, it's kind of bland, but very pretty. Wait, look at this. It kind of looks like raspberry cookies and cream. Like all those little black things in there, I think they're seeds. Hold on. Seeing as nobody else can help me eat this fruit, I'm gonna try some. Okay. Okay. So it's not so soft that I can like, you know, run my upper lip above and just snag some, but I can with my teeth. I can just kind of like rake my teeth across it and get some of the meat. Yeah. So when it comes to dragon fruit, it may have a very like exotic name and very exotic looks, but the taste, in my opinion, kind of bland. Let me know what you think in the comment section down there, and we'll talk about it. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. Maybe I'm supposed to like put a little bit of sugar on it or something. I don't know. You all are really good usually about letting me know when I'm doing things wrong. So this is a guava, and I don't know anything about guavas. I have no idea what to expect. I don't know if this is gonna be like citrusy or if this is gonna be, I don't know what I'm walking into. This is a whole new thing to me. So let's go fruit ninja on it. I shouldn't try it, huh? Probably safe to not do yet. 1, 2. Whoa, oh, this is, wow. It might not be right to call it a woody texture on the outside, but it's a lot harder to cut into than a lot of these other fruits. Oh, that was loud. Whoa. So this is what it looks like on the inside. It's got like seeds or something. I don't know. I guess, can I eat the skin? I think I can eat the skin. I'm gonna try to eat the skin. Skin doesn't seem to be edible. I'm just gonna try to slice this almost like an apple because it's got a texture, like a very firm apple. Okay, I'm admitting defeat. I have no idea how this is edible, how it's supposed to be eaten. Because it's just way too firm. Oh wait, I got a tiny little bit of it. And I think that was a seed. Yeah, I admit defeat, I'm sorry. If you know anything about this fruit and what I've done wrong, let me know in the comment section down below. Because I'm clueless. So here's another one with a really hard like outer shell slash, I don't know, like, maybe you want to call it a rind, I don't know. I don't really know how to get into it, so I'm just gonna do the fruit ninja thing, and I'm just gonna try to slice it, see what we can come up with. I do know that there are little like white, little things in here, and that's what we're supposed to, ooh! So I took the knife and I pressed into it, and it basically fell apart. Leaving the little white, like, meaty parts. Ooh, and it's all squishy! That's cool! Really, like, sweet, too. So, here's one of the little, like, white, meaty parts out of the mangosteen here. Oh my god, it's creamy and tangy and sour in the best possible ways. I love this! This, we have a winner. I want to make a mangosteen shake. So, that's a winner for me. However, one of my roommates is kind of not digging it. But that's okay though. It's got this awesome like personality because it's got the really hard exterior and everything. And then it's on the inside, it's like really soft and sweet and sour too. I like it, it's a lot like me. And last but not least, we have this one and the outside of it, it has this sort of texture almost like a rubbery leather or like a snake egg or something. Sorry for those of you who don't know this, but snake eggs do feel kind of like rubbery leather. And this is definitely not a snake egg. This is something that was grown here in the Philippines. Speaking of, I did, however, I saw a fruit that kind of reminded me of like snake scales. And I was scared to buy it because I'm not a big fan of snakes. If you happen to know what that fruit is, let me know in the comment section down below, because I'm too scared to bite it. So here we go, I'm just gonna cut this in half. I'm gonna try to, here we go. Ho-ho, whoa, holy moly. Oh, what is this? I don't know. It looks all slimy and gross. It looks all goopy. And look, it's all like, I can, ew! Ew! It's like an alien species. So I guess I'm gonna have to try this. Hold on, let me go check with one of my roommates who knows more about this stuff than I do and make sure that this isn't like infected with some kind of like, I don't know. Let me go make sure that this is what it's supposed to look like. Okay, so apparently this is what it's supposed to look like. So I'm just gonna... So I'm not eating the seeds, though I have been told that I could if I wanted to, but the goop around the seeds is actually really good. Like, basically I'm just sucking the goop off of the seeds, which sounds really creepy. Trying to chew the seeds was a very bad idea. It's like the seed basically exploded into my mouth into 1,000 pieces, and now I've just got grit everywhere. Okay, so tonight has been a roller coaster of emotions and of taste bud usage. I think mostly everything I tried here tonight is at the very least a meh, at the greatest a woohoo, and some of them, I'll be honest, I'm not in a hurry to try again. One thing I did want to bring up is this one, which is the mangosteen. This one's got an interesting story to it, and seeing as that's what I do on this channel, I tell stories. I have a roommate who's lived here in the Philippines her entire life. She had never tried a mangosteen. That's so amazing to me because, you know, it's a thing that's really only available here and also in other places here in Southeast Asia. But it's a thing that's really known here in the Philippines, and they hadn't tried it. Let me know in the comment section down below if you live in the Philippines or know someone who hasn't tried mangosteen. I hope this video's been helpful for you. If it has, let us know in the comment section down below. Till next time, don't forget to like, and subscribe, and do all those things that make us love our jobs. Also, be awesome to yourself and amazing to each other. Bye. So good. And tonight, it is night number 2. Let's get brushing. So much for joining me on today's story on my cuento. Be sure to check out one or more of the things on screen now that'll lead you to even more stuff, 'cause it's awesome. Alright, next vlog.